hours away. Hours away of being able to relax and sit on this absolutely beautiful beach. But all of a sudden, no one can get past the airport security checkpoints due to careless systems being put in place, and now your vacation is ruined. Due to one reason, safety. Joseph Paradiso, an associate professor of media arts and science, and Gershon Dublin, who discusses how sensory networks affects human experience, states, there will probably come a time when sensory or neural implants provide that connection. We hope these devices and the information they provide will fold into our existing systems of sensory processing rather than further displacing them. In other words, he hopes that these sensory networks can help contribute to people's senses without fully taking over them. Sensors can be used in the workplace to make tasks and skills more efficient. Technology is implemented in people's everyday lives, whether it's scrolling through social media, watching videos, or communication. American airports are no exception. A set of technology systems are implemented in airports to protect not only the airport, but everyone in it. Hi, I'm Nadia Bushinov, and as a result of this, I ask the question, to what extent is technology, such as sensors and scanners, effective in American airports when ensuring people's safety? After the attack of 9/11, more technology was implemented into airports, such as X-ray machines and metal detectors. The Transportation Security Administration, better known as the TSA, is the head of all security regarding airports. To go inside airport terminals, it's more than just a pat-down. Passengers have to go through a set of security systems before entering the terminals and further on going on their flight. As you can see here in this chart provided by the TSA, up to 120 guns were confiscated off of passengers after going through security systems. Some people argue that technology used to protect airports is not effective whatsoever. All things considered, technology used to protect airports is effective, but to a certain degree, and can be improved because of scanners, X-ray technology, and sensors in order to inform society how their safety is ensured. From a political standpoint, scanners are implemented for the use of detecting harmful items. Allison Young, a member of USA Today's investigation team, takes from Robin Kane, a TSA assistant administrator. He explains how full body scanning is a necessity when preventing the public from an attack such as a terrorist attack. Full body scanning is deemed one of the most important uses of technology in airports provided by the TSA, thus leading to the fact that it is effective in these airports. Gil Overton, an engineer of technology, touches base on the fact that the TSA had to spend $175,000 per scanning unit, having to provide 1,800 units to American airports. In other words, the TSA has to spend a massive amount of money when providing the scanning units, and it comes out from them. Nobody helps them pay for these types for this technology, thus leading to the fact that they need to find a cheaper way to access this technology and provide it to airports. Addressing moral beliefs, X-ray technology is another efficient safety precaution. A peer-reviewed journal, the Journal of Medical Physics, when talking about how X-ray technology is effective, they state, airport security accounts for the majority of this market, of the demand for this market, which consists of a number of variations of X-ray technology. In the simplest terms, the TSA believes that this X-ray technology is one of the most important uses and is in the highest demand at airports. As you can see here, after this guy has gone through an X-ray machine in airports, he was easily caught with a gun on his body. Although X-ray technology helps to keep people safe, passengers have raised concern that it takes away their privacy. James Blair, writer at Christian Science Monitor, when talking about how X-ray technology takes away the privacy of passengers, he states, not surprisingly though, the idea of having someone else look at an X-ray of an individual's anatomy is striking civil libertarians. Specifically, passengers frown upon the idea of someone, an airport official, being able to look at an image like this one here of their bodies after they go through these X-ray securities, thus leading to the fact that X-ray security should not be allowed to take away the privacy of these passengers. Likewise, sensors is another efficient safety precaution. Bruce Narwhal, author at Aviation Week in Space Technology, comments from airport officials that radio frequency sensors can help rapidly track any people who can cause potential threats to an airport, as well as any workers entering terminals who can actually be people posing as workers and can cause potential threats. This efficiently works because it helps airport officials know what can happen to an airport as considering like an attack or any potential threats. Correspondingly, multi-sensor surveillance cameras are cost-effective and a full-time way to monitor airports. However, sensors may not be the most reliable use of technology for airports. Lev Grossman, lead technology writer at Time Magazine, touches base on the fact that Motion sensors beep distressingly when someone is walking off with your device. Although it would be beneficial for these motion sensors to detect when someone is stealing your device, they tend to go off when you have something in your baggage, such as a computer, something that will cause no harm, and is your own device, thus leading to false accusations on passengers. Some people may argue that technology used as security is not effective whatsoever. Some airport officials have raised concern that these technologies are too big and too slow, thus leading to the fact that it should not be used at all. However, this does not provide a set security system for airports, resulting in it being somewhat unrealistic. Going back to what Allison Young stated about scanning units, this is a necessity when protecting airports. Going back to my proposed resolution, it only pertains to international airports and can cause a lot of time when trying to make these changes. It can be implied that if these changes are made to this technology, its purpose stays the same, as well as government cooperation in regards to providing cheaper funding. Everyone can agree that there has to be a set security system when ensuring protection for airports. Overall, technology used to protect airports is effective but needs some improvement. If the changes previously stated were made, more significant technology would be in airports. Privacy concerns would no longer happen, and more reliable technology would be provided for airports. So speak up now. Let airport officials know the best safety options today.
How did your research question evolve as you moved through the research process? Did your research go in a different direction than you originally planned or hypothesized?
So at first, I looked for preliminary articles, known as pre-search, and I was just looking at just how airport security helps to protect the airports, and I wasn't really looking at the specifics of airport technology that people use. So I had a very broad scale. I was just kind of focusing on just scanners in general, not focusing on full body scanners or X-ray machines. So as I started doing more research, my research questions started to evolve and get less broad. Like as I mentioned in my research question, technology such as sensors and scanners. So after going through this research, my research question started to get less broad and more specific. Was there another part of the question?
Did your research go in a different direction than you originally planned?
It actually did, because at first I wasn't really expecting myself to be using specific technologies. I was just focusing on just airport security in general, rather than focusing in on how these technologies work and how it protects airports.
What might be the real-world implications or consequences, like the influence on others' behaviors or decision-making processes, of your findings? What are the implications to your community?
Can you repeat that question?
Sure. What might be the real-world implications or consequences, such as the influence on others' behaviors or decision-making processes, of your findings? What are the implications to your community?
Well, for the real world, if people are looking at airport security in America, in other countries, they might want to use the airport security that we use in order to ensure their safety. I don't want to answer this question right now.
Shame on you, Michelle.
Good answer.
Wait, did you record that?
Yeah,
I still recorded it.
Good answer.
So that was a low blow.